Good afternoon. I'm here to provide an update on the disappearance of Samantha Murphy, who went missing on the 4th of February, and the developments that have came today. Detectives from the missing persons squad yesterday morning at 6 a.m. arrested a 22-year-old Scotsburn man. They arrested him at his home address and took him into custody. The man was interviewed over a number of hours. A number of search warrants have been executed. As a result of those investigations, he has today been charged with the murder of Samantha. We will be alleging that murder occurred at Mount Clare on the day she disappeared. In the interview with the suspect, he has not disclosed to police where Samantha's body is. I want to be very clear. I'm limited in what I can say, given that there has now been a charge of murder laid. The suspect, as I say, has been charged, and he'll be appearing before Ballarat Magistrates Court. As I came into the press conference, he was very close to being fronted before the magistrate. Samantha's family has been advised of this tragic news this afternoon by detectives from the missing persons squad, and obviously this is a tragic outcome, knowing that she has been murdered. Our thoughts and support are with her family. And I do just want to say something about the family. Since the outset in these cases, it's often that the family come under scrutiny. They were under intense scrutiny at the outset, and we, Victoria Police, said everyone should keep an open mind and let us go about our business. They have been cooperative with us. They have provided everything we needed, and they have had no involvement whatsoever in this matter. I want to thank all members of the public, and Ballarat surrounding communities. They've been fantastic in the way they've assisted the volunteers, particularly members of the SES, the CFA. They've helped in the line searches, in continuing searches, but also in the information that has been provided. I know that Samantha's disappearance has had a profound impact on the Ballarat community. Some cases, some disappearances, some murders bring out outpourings of grief, and we've seen that here. So thank you to the community and all those involved, all those who provided assistance in all of those areas. Lastly, I want to thank all of the Victoria Police officers involved, those who've been involved in the searches from the outset, the responders, those specialist areas, search and rescue, a whole range of other areas, those who've been involved in the painstaking and methodical investigation that's occurred in the bush area, but as well, those detectives from the missing persons unit who've worked very long hours, intensive hours since this occurred. They've been assisted by other members from Crime Command, other detectives from there, those from the Western region, as well as detectives from our Counter-Terrorism Command to make sure we had significant resources to solve this case. This investigation is far from over, though. Obviously, we're going to be continuing to gather further evidence, we'll be taking further statements, and investigations will continue at a very heavy pace. Importantly, doing everything we can to locate Samantha's body for the family is absolutely vital and something we'll be focusing on. I would call on the public. We've had amazing assistance in terms of intelligence reports being made, but anyone who has any information, even the slightest bit of information that you think might not be that relevant, please call Crime Stoppers on 1800 333 000. Any little clue could be vital in helping us locate her body. I'm happy to answer any questions, but as I say, I am very limited in what I can tell you, given that a person has now been charged with murder.
Will police be able to allege whether the 22-year-old charged man is known to Samantha or her family?
It's my understanding this man is not known to the family.
There are reports that you're searching now for her remains. Is that true?
I'm not going to go into operational detail as to where we're searching for remains. The search has been ongoing for a period of time. And it continues whenever we get additional information. But we're calling on members of the public to help us because that's our primary role now, to try and get Samantha back for her family.
Is he cooperating with police, the man accused?
It's not for me to comment on whether the suspect has cooperated with police or not. I will simply say that he has been charged with murder and he has not disclosed where her body is.
Do police believe that he worked on his own, or are you looking for other people as well?
We're not looking for anyone else. It's not alleged at this stage that there's any accomplice.
Murder is premeditated. Will police allege whether this was planned or it was an accident?
He has been charged with murder, so by its definition, we're saying this was a deliberate attack on Samantha.
So you suggest it's opportunistic?
I'm not going to go into the details, motive, or any of those further details in regards to what has or hasn't happened when she has been killed. I will simply say he has been charged with murder, which by its definition means it was an intentional act.
How did police find this man? Was it the mobile phone data? Was it a tip from the public?
He's been located through a range of investigative outcomes that have come together. As you would be aware, we've been clear, we've been pinging phones, we've been following up on investigation reports from members of the public, we've done ground searches, we have done door knocks, so it's a whole range of information coming together. I'm not going to identify what has specifically led us to this man, other than to say it has resulted, as came about from painstaking detective work, with great assistance from the public.
How do you believe Samantha died, if that's the assumption being made?
I'm not going to go into the details of how Samantha died. I'm simply going to say she was murdered on the day of her disappearance by this man.
Are police also looking for a weapon as well?
We continue to look for evidence in respect to the murder.
Was the accused known to police previously?
I'm not going to go into whether the accused is known to police or not.
Why wasn't the arrest disclosed until today, when I believe it was 6 a.m. yesterday when it occurred?
We don't disclose operational matters that could impede or in any way impair our investigation.
Has the search area narrowed since his arrest, or changed perhaps?
As I say, I'm not going to go into details of anything to do with the outcome of the investigation at this stage or what it might mean. We're still at a critical stage of this investigation where we are trying to locate Samantha's body as well as a whole range of other evidence. So it's not appropriate that I give a blow-by-blow description about what we're going to do, what we might be doing, or what our investigation may take us towards. It's simply this. We have identified, through a very painstaking, methodical investigation, an offender. We've charged that person with murder. They are now, or could be at this very moment, or will have a short time ago, or this evening, be fronting at Ballarat Magistrates Court to face that charge. But again, and I really do want to reiterate it, we are calling on members of the public who may know even the slightest snippet of information. Please contact Crime Stoppers.
Are you able to say when Samantha's family was told about the arrest and how they received the news?
Samantha's family was told about the arrest last night, and they were told this afternoon about the charging of the male. I won't go into how they've received the news. Obviously, though, anyone being told a loved one has been murdered, it's tragic.
So was the day that she went missing, you believe she was killed?
We're alleging she was murdered at Mount Clear on the day of her disappearance, the 4th.
I understand you're not able to give too much detail, but is there a physical search currently happening today for her body?
I'm not going to go into any details about what the investigation is doing at the moment.
Will police be alleging that this was a hit run?
No.
Where were the search warrants you mentioned before that had been executed in the last day since the arrest? Where were they executed?
We executed a number of search warrants yesterday at some residential addresses in that area of the vicinity of where the male lives in Scottsburn.
Can you disclose, say, how many homes?
No, I'm not going into that.
Was a car allegedly involved at all?
I'm not going to go into any further detail other than to say this was a, we are alleging, a deliberate attack which has caused the death of Samantha.
You've said that he wasn't known to the family. Was he known to Samantha?
I don't have that knowledge. I don't believe that to be the case.
Is your interaction with the man refined to the parameters in which you're searching for the body at all?
Again, I'm not going to scope down what the investigation extent will or won't be. It's not helpful for anyone to speculate on what the outcomes now of the investigation mean for us, where we, what our avenues of inquiry take us to. We will be led by the evidence, and there's still a whole range of it that we're processing, and that's what we'll do, and we'll continue to do this in a methodical approach, as has been to date.
Why did you, as Chief Commissioner, decide you needed to speak to us today about this?
Yeah, I thought it was important I came here because such has been the outpouring of grief in the community. The feeling of emotion that we've heard right across not just the Ballarat and surrounding area, but right across Victoria, indeed across the nation and internationally. It was important for me to stand here to express my appreciation to the public, the members of all those communities who've assisted, the information we've got from them, but as well to the police officers who've been engaged in this and given up many hours of long, long haul days so that I can say to them, thank you for what you've done. And because of the importance of that, that's why I'm standing here.
And have you spoken to any witnesses specifically relating to the movements of the accused?
I'm not going to go into details about what the investigation has or hasn't done to date. It's just not something I'm going to touch upon. The person has been charged, so now we are bound by a number of rules in relation to what we can and can't say in regards to evidence, and this is where we're at.
What prosecutors are you opposing bail?
It's a charge of murder. We'll be opposing bail.
Are you alleging some sort of weapon of any kind was used?
I haven't alleged what transpired in the death, other than that this is a deliberate attack which has resulted in the murder of Samantha.
Was that a motorbike weapon?
Again. I'm not going to speculate on any other details about the death other than to say it was deliberate.
Is there any alleging of whether drugs or alcohol were involved on part of the charged man?
Again, I'm not going to go into the evidence and speculate about the evidence. So in Victoria, when someone's charged, irrespective of what people's views may be, the details of that evidence are tested in court, not at press conferences.
Just to confirm something that you said earlier, so it's not being treated as an alleged hit run?
No.
Was Samantha Murphy's family hopeful of from here? I imagine they're obviously distraught. Are they really, in terms of recovering her, is that something that's of the utmost importance to them?
Oh, obviously. It goes without saying, any family or someone who's lost a loved one, the recovery of Samantha is of primary importance to them to get their loved one back. And that's why the focus from our investigators will be not stepping back at all. In fact, we'll be going even harder to try and recover a body.
Is there a sexual nature to the murder?
Again, I'm not going to canvass any details to do with the evidence in respect to the murder. All right, thank you all.